local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
State health officials say a primary school in Greenwood County has a tuberculosis outbreak on its hands tonight. What that means for the families and why the state says this is not as bad as it sounds. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Gabrielle Komorowski. Carol is off today. DHEC is calling it an official TB outbreak in Greenwood County.
But at the same time, they're saying the community does not need to worry about more people becoming infected. News 4's Nigel Robertson joins us now with more on the story. Nigel?
They are calling it an outbreak, but DHEC says they do not expect anyone else to become so sick that they'll start spreading it as well. People down here in the Greenwood area are nervous.
It was a madhouse down here.
And angry.
I'm very upset. Very upset.
Inside the Greenwood Department of Health and Environmental Control.
Every 5 minutes, the door was opening. Another child being brought in with their parents, grandparents, or whatever, coming in, don't know what the outcome is going to be.
8 of the 58 are children who had positive chest x-rays. DHEC says that means they have the disease, but that form of childhood TB is not infectious, not contagious, and is not considered a public health risk.
Now our 8-year-old has to go through 9 months of medicine and coming up here to be tested.
The fear has led Catherine Templeton, the DHEC director, to get in front of the camera to say this.
Anyone who may have been infected by that individual would have been infected probably in January or February of this past year. And if you have not set foot in the 96 primary elementary school this school year, you are not at risk of being affected by this tuberculosis outbreak.
But anyone who has been in personal contact with the individual may also be infected.
What's remarkable about this situation is not only was the index patient very contagious, but also the germ that he has been putting out there is also very virulent, or has a lot of what we call pathogenicity. Not only can it cause infection, but it can also cause disease in a greater percentage of patients.
Now, the 8 children will get months of treatment, and after that, they will be cured. DHEC says the investigation is far from over, and more people will be tested. Gabby?
Nigel, thank you. Now, many of you have asked us to explain what tuberculosis is. MedicalNewsToday.com describes it as an infectious disease caused by a bacteria that can infect any organ, but primarily affects the lungs. The bacteria multiplies in the lungs. It causes pneumonia, along with chest pain, coughing up blood, and prolonged coughing. As the TB tries to spread, the body's immune system forms scar tissue around the bacteria, and if it is successful, this will stop the disease from spreading throughout the body. Doctors say anyone can get tuberculosis. In fact, here are some statistics from the World Health Organization. Someone in the world is newly infected with TB every second. Overall, 1/3 of the world's population is currently infected with TB, but only between 5% and 10% of people who are infected with TB become actively sick. TB is generally classified as being either latent or active. Medical News Today says latent TB occurs when the bacteria are present in the body. However, there are no symptoms and it is not contagious. The Mayo Clinic says people with active TB are contagious and usually display symptoms of coughing, unintentional weight loss, fatigue, fever, night sweats, chills, and loss of appetite. Now, we know this is a lot to take in, so just head to WYFF4.com, and there we have posted more information on symptoms and how TB spreads.
Get out. That is the warning tonight for anyone in a violent relationship, and it comes from a Greenville County family. They lost a loved one this morning in what deputies call a domestic disturbance in Taylor's. News 4's Angela Rodriguez joins us live and local. She's outside the Greenville Law Enforcement Center. Angela, there is a violent history in this case, right?
Michael, according to the family, this was a rocky relationship, especially when alcohol was involved. Tonight, we know Teresa Valentine is dead and her boyfriend charged with murder.
It's the call a Greenville County family dreaded.
10:30 this morning, the Greenville County Sheriff's Office received a disturbance call here on Brown Street.
Authorities say that disturbance led to Teresa Valentine's death. Investigators say her live-in boyfriend, Richard Ashford, stabbed her at least twice.
We were trying to help her, but we couldn't get around him.
Loved ones say Valentine feared something like this would happen, but this is how her family wants to remember her, with a smile on her face.
She was sweet, happy, person. And I love her weakness.
And to other families who have seen love go wrong, they have this warning.
I say to them, get out while you can.
Investigators say Ashford did not leave the scene of the crime. Tonight, he is being held in the Greenville County Detention Center awaiting a bond hearing. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Greenville.
Angela, thank you. The man accused in a late-night murder was in court today. Anderson police say they arrested 29-year-old Curtis Fowler last night. In court this morning, Fowler requested a public defender. Police say he killed 40-year-old Brian Howard at a home on Martin Avenue on Friday night. The coroner says Howard was shot once in the head.
You may know this. School is out for the summer this week in Greenville County, and the Greenville police chief wants to remind students and their parents the curfew is still in effect in the downtown. Chief Terry Wilfong told us today that extra officers will police the Central Business District Friday for the start of summer break. Chief says the biggest problem is that some of the teens get down there and get into fights, leading to a big disruption of an otherwise peaceful place to be.
A lot of times parents would, in the past, send the kids down there and say, we'll be back at midnight to pick you up, or not all the parents know we have a curfew.
So here is that curfew to remember. It is on Friday and Saturday nights and on holidays. It starts at 10 o'clock at night. This means if you're 17 or younger, you must be with an adult in the downtown Central Business District after those curfew times. If you get caught, the teen will be detained, parents called, and the parents can be given a ticket.
An upstate company is shutting its doors, leaving dozens without jobs. State Representative Mike Campbell says the 77 employees at Joy Global were told on Friday that the company in Anderson County is closing. The company expects to close by November. We're told the county is trying to help find the workers new jobs. And Representative Campbell said the county is also trying to set up a meeting with Joy Global to see if they can prevent the company from closing.
That we have a lot of new companies coming into Anderson, and a lot of those people who work there are very technically skilled positions. As a matter of fact, we've already talked with some companies in the area who are interested in getting a list of those people and their skills to possibly hire them.
Joy Global makes conveyors for the mining industry.
Passengers using GSP will want to take note of this. Southwest Airlines is canceling two of its direct flights out of the area. Orlando and one of the two Baltimore flights will drop off the schedule later this summer and fall. The company says it needs the planes to move into AirTran markets where the two companies have merged, and the cancellations already have some people at GSP concerned.
Because I love Southwest. We love everything about them, my husband and I. The customer service and, you know, the fact that they're, you know, we've had very little problems anytime we've ever flown Southwest. It's so convenient.
And Southwest told WYFF 4 the company is still thrilled to be here, but it was a matter of moving planes to the most profitable routes possible. And Southwest added, quoting here, we are pleased with the booking out of GSP to other markets. We will continue to monitor our load factors, close quote. And this may help pick up the slack. GSP execs tell us Allegiant Air is considering adding more direct flights coming up to Orlando.